Everyone, warm welcome you all. Yes friends, in today's video we are going to discuss an important form of poetry, that is ode. Yes friends, aaj hum ode discuss karenge kyunki important form of poetry hai, and there are three types of ode. We will discuss all that here in this video details. And yes friends, I want to tell you all, if you want the PDF of the videos uploaded on this channel, अगर आप PDF चाहते हो जो भी videos मैंने upload किए हुए हैं इस channel पे, then please join the membership of this channel. And yes, आपको link membership join करने का वो description box में मिल जाएगा. आप उस पे चल के उसके details check कर सकते हो and join the membership of this channel to get the PDF uploaded on this channel. And yes friends, now move on to the topic of the day. Forms of poetry, and in that category we will discuss ode, which has three parts: Pindaric, Horatian and irregular ode. Let's discuss that in details. Friends, first we will discuss what is ode. Yes friends, the ode accompanied by music, dance. Yes, it is a form of poetry which is in lyric form. Lyric form mein ye poetry hoti hai, and it is a formal address to an event. Dance and music must be in the form of poetry, which is we are discussing here, that is ode. These are the required things. ये required things हैं जो कि dance and music ode में होना चाहिए by the poet जो compose करता है poetry related to this category, this genre of poetry. And this is a formal address to an event, a person and a thing not present. Yes, ये एक formal address होता है in which poet addresses something. He addresses some event, he recalls some memories, and he recalls nature's person which are even not presented before him. That is the formal address by the poet. And the name comes from the Greek aden. Yes, ode jo meaning word hai, it came from the Greek word aden se liya gaya hai. Aden se isko kiya gaya hai, meaning टू सिंग और चैंट. इसका क्या मतलब होता है? इसका मतलब है चैंट करना या गाना गाना. एंड बिलोंग्स टू द लॉन्ग एंड वरीड ट्रेडिशन ऑफ लिरिक पोएट्री. यस, दिस फॉर्म ऑफ पोएट्री विच इज ऑड, इट बिलोंग्स टू द लिरिक कैटेगरी ऑफ पोएट्री. जो लिरिक पोएट्रीज होती हैं जिसमें म्यूजिक होते हैं, डांस होते हैं, इमोशंस होते हैं, इट बिलोंग्स टू द रिदम होता है एंड मीटर्स होते हैं. इट बिलोंग्स टू लिरिकल पोएट्री एंड इट इज things to sing or chant. ये formal address होता है which is believed to be sing or chant. Now let's discuss the types of ode. We have three types of ode in English literature, that is Pindaric, Horatian and irregular ode. And now let's discuss the Pindaric ode in details. The Pindaric is the first form of the ode and it is a types of ode. Pindaric is a name from for the ancient Greek poet Pindar. Yes friends, ye ancient Greek poet Pindar the, unke naam se ye odd hua hai, that is known as, named after Greek poet Pindar, and it is named as Pindaric ode. And who is credited with innovative this choral ode from sung by the chorus in classic Greek drama? Yes friends, ye cred because of him this form of poetry which is odd, it has a innovative things given by the Greek poet Pindar, and which is sung by the chorus in the classical Greek drama. जो classical Greek dramas हुआ करते थे उसमें जो chorus songs गाते थे, that has credited with innovative things by the Greek poet Pindar, and that's why it was named after him as and known in English literature as Pindaric ode. Next we have Pindaric ode were performed with a chorus and dancers and often composed to celebrate athletic victories. Yes, it is believed that this form of poetry is performed with chorus, with a chorus and dancers. Jo chorus hote the, jo isko sing karte the, gaate the, aur dancers hua karte, because dance and music both are important in ode. They contain a formal opening that is known as a strophe or complex metrical structure. The strophe, isme teen important cheeze hoti hai, strophe, antistrophe and epode. These three things are found in Pindaric ode. Or strophe is known as the complex metrical structure. Ye complex metrical structure hota hai, followed by antistrophe which is mirrors the opening, and epode the final closing section of a different length and composed with different matrical structure. Yes, जो pandaric odes होते हैं, they has three things important: strophe, antistrophe, and epode. These three things have a required in composing pandaric odd. Also, friends, this form of poetry, pandaric odd, popularized in the 1600 by Abraham Cowley in English literature, in English, in England, or in the history of English literature, employing line of regular, irregular lengths and an irregular rhyme scheme, because it has the nature, and odd has a nature that it has written or composed in different rhythmic structure, different lengths of poetry. And in England, it was popularized by Abraham Cowley in the 1600. Next, we have the William Wordsworth poem Odd on Imitations of Immortality from Recollections of Early Childhood, is a very good example of English language pandaric odd. It has the best example we have of William Wordsworth poem Odd on Imitations of Immortality from Recollection of Early Childhood, which has a category of pandaric odd, जो pandaric odd से belong करती है. It has written in odd form, but in odd form, the type of odd, it has pandaric odd. Next we have the Horatian odd. Next, another form of or types of odd we have. The Horatian odd, named after the Roman poet Horace. Yes friend, जैसे Greek poet के name से pandaric odd जाना जाता है, वैसे ही Horatian poet जो थे, Horace थे, Roman poet. This form of poetry or this another type of odd is known by his name. Horatian odd is informal, meditative, and intimate. Yes, friends, it is something little bit different with the pandaric odd, because pandaric odd mein formal address hua karta tha, but it has informal, meditative, intimate, and it was composed by the poet. These odds dwelt upon interesting subject matter that were simple, gave pleasure to sense. Yes, it this form of poetry is another form of odd which was written in the Horatian odd. The poets composed under this category of form, they had a interesting subject matter and also simple, and it has a simplicity. It has written in simple lines, in very simple meters, simple length, and give pleasure to sense. It has a sensitivity, it has a giving pleasure to the sense. Since Horatian odds are informal in tone, they are devoid of strict rules. Yes friends, they have nothing to do with strict rules. They are very easy understanding, very easy to compose, very easy to read out, or very easy to sing. The Horatian ode typically uses a regular recurrent stanza pattern, and is at the best example we have the Ellen Tate's poem Ode to the Confederate Dead. This is the example of the Horatian ode. It was the poem composed by Ellen Tate, poet जो थे, Ellen Tate ने compose किया है ये poem. And like, not like in pandaric odd, it has a simple rhythmic structure. It is written in informal tone, and it gives pleasure to senses. Senses को ये pleasure देता है. This is the form of the Horatian. This is the nature of the Horatian odd. Now let's discuss another and the last third part form of the odd. Now discuss the irregular odd. This type of odd is without any formal rhyme scheme and structure. Yes friends, earlier we had discussed pandaric odd and Horatian odd. In pandaric odd, while composing that type of odd, poet must have follow strict rules of rhythmic style and structure and concept, and also the moods of the strict rules. They had a formal address, and in Horatian odd they were informal address, and they were not as strict as pandaric odd. But the irregular odd, you can think of it, you can assume it by its name, aap isko andaaza laga sakte ho uske name se, that it is known as irregular odd. That's why it is without any formal rhyming scheme and structure. The poet has a great freedom and flexibility to try any type of mood and concepts, whatever the poet's mood and he's trying to compose or poetry, he can write, he can compose that poetry under the subcategory, under the type of poetry, under the type of ode that is irregular ode. And William Wordsworth and John Keats were such poets who extensively wrote irregular ode. And for example, if you regard nothing, ode on a Grecian urn is the poetry, is the poem of John Keats, and it was based on his experiments with the sonnet. And other well-known ode, including Percy Bysshe Shelley's Ode to the West Wind, this is comes under the category of the ode that is irregular ode. Robert Crilly's America, Bernadette's, and all Robert Lowell's Quaker Graveyard is Nantucket is another form of एग्जाम्पल ऑफ दी इरेगुलर ऑड. सो फ्रेंड्स, आज हमने जो डिस्कस किया यहाँ पे, हमने फॉर्म ऑफ पोएट्री डिस्कस की है जिसमें हमने ऑड डिस्कस किया, उसके थ्री टाइप्स डिस्कस करे हैं. आगे आने वाले वीडियोज में कुछ और अनदर फॉर्म ऑफ पोएट्री हम डिस्कस करेंगे. आज थोड़ा मेरा गला खराब होने की वजह से वो कंटिन्यूटी या वो आपको एंथुसियाज्म नहीं दिख रहा है, नहीं समझ आ रहा है इस वीडियो को बनाते वक्त. बट इस वीडियो जो भी मैंने कंटेंट यहाँ पे यूज किया है, कंटेंट हम मैंने यहाँ पे आपके लिए मैं लेके आई हूँ इन्फॉर्मेशन, दे ऑल आर वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट. एंड यस, आप इससे आपके ऑड से रिलेटेड कॉन्सेप्ट को क्लियरली समझ सकते हो. एंड प्लीज फ्रेंड, अगर आप सब्सक्राइब कर फर्स्ट टाइम विजिट कर रहे हो तो सब्सक्राइब करना मत भूलिए. एंड यस, कीप वॉचिंग इंग्लिश जोन. थैंक यू वेरी मच फॉर वॉचिंग दिस.